This will be setup of the Tapo C325WB. First things first, if you haven't done so already, you're gonna download the Tapo application. You will then come up to the plus sign in the upper right-hand corner, and you are going to find your Tapo camera. So we're just gonna hunt through here until we locate our camera. I do like how they broke this out. Notice that they break it out: cameras, plugs, bulbs, strips, power hub, sensors. I kinda like that. So here's our camera. We're gonna select that, and we're gonna select, is this gonna be wired or is this gonna be wireless? In my case, I'm going to do this wirelessly, and we're gonna select next. And now we have to plug in the camera. It's gonna start blinking, letting us know that it's all good to go. Now, what I'm going to recommend, grab yourself the little waterproof washer ahead of time and place that in the power receptacle there, and then power on your device. This way you already have the water seal and you don't have to worry about it. So we're just gonna get that right in there, kind of get that around there, plug it in, which I'm gonna adjust so that I know that I'm getting a watertight seal. Kind of look around like that, see it's all the way around, and then link it in. There we go. And bringing the camera back into focus over here, we could see that I have a red light, but we want to wait for the red and green blinking like it is starting now. So we're going to select next. All right. If you're on an Android phone, you are going to have to enable location. So we're going to select enable while using this app. I'll select, and we're going to go back to next. We have to connect to the Wi-Fi network that this is pushing out. Here we go. I had to do a little finagling, but it's letting me know Tapo wants to temporarily connect to the phone. I'm going to select connect. It's letting me know that it's successful. And now the two are talking. Notice the light's still blinking there because it's looking for the Tapo device. And sadly, I had a notification pop up, but this is what popped up. It says, what network do you want? You can select your network and then password. If you have not used a Tapo device before, you'll plug in your password. And in my case, it's already saved. So, and it appears that they have not fixed this portion, which I dislike greatly, which is showing you your network and password in plain text. Tapo, fix that. I hear the camera making some noise. So that's going to be it connecting itself to the Wi-Fi network. So it is connecting to your network. We're still blinking green and red right there. Ooh, now we're kind of on a steady amber.
Wi-Fi connected.
And you probably heard what. Okay, there will be no doubt that you understand when this is connected to your network. It is rather loud. I'm going to leave this page because I've had this experience with Tapo products. They tend to get hung up on the connection phase here. We can clearly see that the green light is on. You can see Tapo camera is now connected with my Alex A devices. But as I was saying, the camera light is clearly green. This is still in the connecting phase. It did audibly tell me that it was connected. Oh, here we go. Now it's pairing to Tapo device. At least the screen changed with the language. All right, I tap the screen and it changed. So here we're going to name our device, and there I'm going to be super clever with my naming. Where is this located? It gives you a couple of pre-builts, but we're going to call this, as this camera is going to be located outside. You can even pick a icon for the device. Looks like by default it was on that baby thing right there. I'm going to select that as my icon and move on. Ready to go at this time. I can select sounds good, or I can go through the mount to wall and it will give me the directions for mounting this to a wall. I'm going to skip that as they do cover that in the instructions. So we're going to say sounds good. We have the option to start their free Tapo care service. So that's a 30-day free trial. I might come back and try that a little later. I'm going to skip for now. You can always go to cameras and turn it back on. So I'm going to say got it. Next, it's letting us know we should put a micro SD card in here. We can get up to a 256 gig card, and it's going to require us to take off the little door right there. So I'm going to say got it, because we're going to need that for the local storage. Here is an auto update for the firmware check. It's letting you know it'll do that between 3 a.m. and 5 a.m., which is kind of nice. It'll be updating off cycle. So I'm going to say got it, and we'll just leave that alone. And here we have the Tapo C325WB, and we're just going to turn that there. And it's kind of walking you through some of the important features that this has: 2K resolution, the super night vision color, smart AI detection, and customizable sounds and alarms. We're going to say got it, and that loads it up. And there we go. That is the setup process for the Tapo C325WB.